Myself, Ankita Ketiwari, from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, from ITICT department, I am going to take a session from Module 2, that is Combinational Circuits, from subject Digital Fundamentals. The topic that we are going to cover in this session is K-maps. Now, whenever we are talking about K-maps, K-maps are graphical representations of Boolean functions. Now, what do you mean by Boolean? Boolean represents only two values, that is 0 or 1. Now, that is represented by, if I am talking about K-map, that means it is a table structure. Now, whenever we are talking about table, it contains cell. Cell is represented by rows and it is represented by a column. So, here one map cell corresponds to a row in the truth table. Now, with respect to truth table of the Boolean function, the value is coded into the K-map and the value has been reduced with the minimum function. Now, here if I am talking about function, then it contains many values as terms. If I am talking about terms, then we are having different values with different notations. So here K-map is represented by a form of a table which is being putted into the table by having some specific forms. So that is known as mean terms or max terms. So what do you mean by mean term and max term? That we have already studied in SOP and POS. Now what do you mean by SOP and POS? These are different forms or representations of K-map itself. So SOP is sum of product and POS is product of sum. So here sum of product is represented by mean terms and POS, that is product of sum, is represented by max term. So sum of product and product of sum, both values are represented by two of the variables, that is mean terms and max terms. So basically whenever we are going to represent any value into the K-map, it is represented by Boolean, that is 0 or 1. But if I am talking about the two terms, that is mean terms or max term, then mean term is represented in K-map by value 1 and max term is represented in K-map by value 0. So whenever we are putting any variable declaration or variable reduction in K-maps, then it is represented by mean terms or max terms in the Boolean expression. So here the multiple cell areas of the map corresponds to standard terms. Now what do you mean by standard? That is SOP and POS. So here that multiple areas includes rows and columns. So we have already known that a cell corresponds to a row in the truth table. So with respect to truth table, the value of the variables, it is quoted in the K-map and it is reduced with the help of its rules. So here we'll start with different types of K-maps which is being used. If I am talking about a question which contains two variables, now two variables means A and B. A and B variable means four possible combinations. How we are getting that? With the formula, that is 2 raised to n. So here 2 means 2 raised to 2, which is equals to 4. So we are having four possible combinations of two variable mapping. Now with respect to two variable mapping, here the structure of K-map is defined as, you can see here in the diagram itself, x1 and x2, two variables, we have named it. You can write it as A and B, C, D, anything that you want. So we have represented x1 and x2 with four possible combinations, as you can see, m0, m1, m2 and m3. Now if I am talking about m0, so its value for x1, x2 means two variable will be 0, 0. So that whole box, that whole cell is represented by 0th bit. As you can see in M0, we have written 0. Same thing if I am going forward, M1. So 0, 1. 0, 1 means 1. So it is written as 1. Second, going downward, if I am comparing the value itself, x1 is 1. As you can see, the structure is defined. And x2 is 0. So it is 10. 10 is represented in Boolean or in binary as 2. So 2 is represented as m2. So there we have written 2. Now the last term, that is 1 and 1. So both value, x1 is also 1 and x2 is also 1. So there it is represented in binary as 3. So there we have written 3 and it is defined as m3. So this small m is represented as mean terms, which is corresponding with the values itself which are you are using it. Or we can write it as, we can change the position of x1 and x2. As you can see, x1 and x2. So x2 and x1 also we can write it. Just we have to see the order or the value of x1 and x2. And then keeping that order in mind, we can put the values in KMap. Okay, so structure or the values will not change, just the position is changing, but that doesn't mean its value will change. No, its value should never change, and whenever you are putting any KMap value in table itself, it should be correctly defined how it is defined in the function. So that thing we have to keep in mind whenever we are reducing the variable using KMap. Okay, so we have to keep some note that is ordering of variables is very important. If it is not maintained, answer will be, but of course it will be wrong, because we know if I am using a Boolean function and if I am reducing it using loss, we should get the same answer as we are reducing using KMap. It should not change. So for that, ordering of variables is very important for any function, for two variable, for three variable, or any of the variable. And x1 is 0, as we can see from the table itself, x1 is 0 and x2 is the column. That you have to keep in mind always with the value. So cell 0 represents x1 bar, x2 bar. So as I have already said, that zero path will have the value as x1 bar and x2 bar. Okay, cell 1 represents, we know, x1 bar, x2, that is 0, 1, etc. Like minimum, all the items are been represented like that only. So if a mean term is present in the system or in the section, then A1 is placed in the corresponding cell. If a mean term is present, then we have, if I am representing mean term, I will represent that mean term by one value. Okay, so this is what about two variable mapping. Now I'm talking about, we'll take one example and we will understand how a two variable KMap or reducing is being done. So here we'll take an example. Suppose we are having like this structure, means that 1 1 1 three values are given. Okay, that three values are been put with the form of question itself. So suppose I'm having a question that is f of x1 x2. So here I'm having x1 plus x2, two values are given. So we'll put that value as x1, okay, x2, with the help of the three terms which are given, x1 bar, x2 bar. So first term, zero term is active, then x1 bar, x2, so that term, another term is active, x1, x2 bar, that means that one term is active. So three terms are active, that is 0, that is 1 and 2. Third term is absent, so we have put a 0 there, and now we will reduce it. Now we can make a pair. Now how to make a pair, that is very important. You can, if I am representing any form in a form of table, see, it is a square form. That means we can make a pair in square itself. Okay, if we cannot make a pair diagonally, okay, we can make pair in a straight line, but with the order of binary itself. That is 2 raised to 0 means 0 pair, 2 raised to 1 means 2 pair, 2 raised to 2 means 4 pair, 2 raised to 3 means 8 pair, 2 raised to 4 means 16. That means with this order only we can make the pairs, because Boolean value, Boolean means binary. So here, as from the table itself, we can see that if we cannot make the pairs diagonally, okay, that means we have to make the pairs in the order of in line only, or in the form of square and together itself in the form of square only. Okay, that means in a straight line also, and diagonally also, the four corners also, if I am representing the four corners, okay, and if I am combining it, then also it will become a square only. Okay, so that square, okay, combination of four corners, a straight line in a four pair. Okay, now in a straight line, it is a box structure. In a straight line means it's a four pair. In a box type, like 1 2 3 4, so four pair. Okay, 8 pair means every pair, everyone is everywhere, it is one, and we are combining the whole square. Okay, so these are different combinations which can happen with respect to the numbers or the order which is given. Okay, now suppose if I'm talking about here, we can make two pair. We have to take the maximum pair as the highest pair, as the one pair. Okay, that means whenever your option is given to reduce it, first of all you have to make the highest pair possible, if it is possible. If it is not, then we will go one less to it, then we'll go one less to it. Okay, so here, as we can see that it is a four combination box, it is, so maximum how many values can be combined, four at a particular time, not more than that. So 2 raised to 2 means 4. Only 4 pair we can take the highest value. But here 4 is not possible because 1 is 0. 3 are only 1. So we cannot make a 4 pair. So we have to go to the 1 less. 1 less means 2 raised to 2. After 1 less is 2 raised to 1. 2 raised to 1 means 2. So 2 pair is possible. Now 2 pair, how we will take it? We have to take 2 of the 1s together. Means we cannot take diagonally, okay? We have to take in the straight line itself. So we can see that first pair is that only, that straight line, and in the diagonal side, as you, side, you can see the one pair. Okay, so two pairs are possible, the horizontally and vertically. So two pairs, and we will write that answer. How we will write that answer? You have to make a pair. How? You have to combine with taking common. As you can see in the first, that is horizontal, as you can see that. In horizontal, you can see the two of the pairs. What is common? X1 as a 0 is common. And X2 is varying, 0 and 1. So we'll ignore that and we'll take the common part from it. So X1, so we got answer as X1. Okay, as you can see here. Now the see the second pair, that is vertically. Okay, in vertically, as you can see, what is common? X2 as a 0. X1 is varying, 0 and 1. So what is common? X2. So answer we got as X1 plus X2. So this is what pairing has been done. So first placed in K-map for specified mean terms of M0, M1 and M2. Then reduce it and we will get the answer. So grouping of ORing of 1s allows simplification. What simpler simplification is? So as you can see, X1 bar is equals to M0 plus M1 and X2 bar is equals to M0 plus M2. And you will get answer as M0, M0 twice. So we will get the answer as X1 plus X2. Now we will moving forward for 3 variable K-map. In 3 variable K-map, cell will be 2 raised to 3, which is equal to 8. So here the cells are, 8 cells are possible. With C as only 2 variable, you can take as A, B, C also. Order can be changed, but the value which is put inside the K-map should not change. It should be proper with the value itself. So here C, A, B we have put it, and with respect to that only we will put the values at 0 and 1. Okay, A, B as 4 possible combination, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1 and 1, 0. Now C, the structure, 0, 0, 0, 1. It should be 1, 0. It is put it there. So this is the basic structure itself. It is fixed. We have to take and we have to use it. Okay, so that order you have to keep in mind always. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and then 1, 1. Okay, and then you have to put all the values, 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so that is what 4, 5, 6 and 7. Like that it should be. But here it is not like that because C, A, B it is given, not A, B, C. Okay, so it is 0, 2, 4, 6. 1, 3, 5 and 7. Like that. If you will count it, you will get the answer. Okay, so this is what you have to keep always in mind, the order. Okay, now we'll see one example. As we are taking the 4 terms and we are taking in the form of mean terms, 4 values we are putting in the K-map. We are reducing it. Okay, and we'll get the answer A bar C bar plus AC. Okay, so this is what 3 variable K-map is. Now we'll see the 3 variable K-map using max term. We should see both the examples. So here I'm taking you with an example of pi, that is pi is represented as max term, that is capital M. So here that is always represented by 0. We have to make a pair of 0 and answer we will get a product of sum, not sum of product. So here as you can see 0, 0, 0, 0. So here we are combining 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros are there. So maximum 4 pair is possible, but 4 pair are not combined together because it is not given directly. So we have to make 2 pairs. So this one pair, okay, that 0, 0, one pair, and that 0 and here 0, that 3 pair. Okay, why we are getting 3 pairs? Because we have to combine all the zeros. No zero should be left out. So we have to make pairs for zeros as we are doing that pairs in mean terms. Okay, and we will get the answer as x plus y dot x plus y plus z dot z plus x. Okay, now 4 variable K-map, the number of cells in 4 variable K-map is 16. Since it is 4, 2 raised to 4 means 16. So 16 possible combination A, B, C, D. okay, the same thing AB, if I'm talking about, so 0001, 10 and 11, okay, the same thing, 0001, 10 and 11, okay, that thing is represented in the form of table and the values are represented in the table itself. Now, with respect to four variable, we'll see one example. As you can see, we have taken four terms, okay, three terms, and I have represented that in here in the K-map itself, and we have reduced. See, as you can see, one vertical line, 1, 1, 1, 1. So here four pair at max at the one time, and now we have to make pairs for the others, one left, which are left to make the pairs. So here, as you can see, horizontally 1, 1. And 1, 1. So we can use the ones which are already being used to make a highest pair. So that can be also a rule, means we can use for making the highest pair. Okay, so wherever it is useful, we can use it. So this is the horizontal and one diagonal, and the 4, 1 which is left, for that we are making a 4 highest pair. So three terms we will get it. Okay, that is W X bar plus YZ. WY plus YZ bar. Okay, five variable K-map. In five variable, it is not possible, it is in K-map, but I will show you the diagram how it looks. That is V equal to 0, V equal to 1. So we'll get 2 raised to 5 means 16, means 32 possible combination, and that we have to make a pair. It is very difficult. So we are not using five variable in K-map. For that, another method has been introduced, that is tabulation method, that we are going to study in the next session. Okay, so this is what five variable K-map is. So here we have ended with the K-maps with the basic terms, two variable K-map, three variable K-map, four variable K-map, and representation of a five variable K-map. Thank you.